This is it. We're at the site build portion of the course. Now, as we already know from our talks on content strategy, every part of this website build we're about to do has to serve the user story we created. As a homeowner, I want to see great interior design work so that I can pick this interior design firm with confidence. Something so important, we printed out copies and taped them to our wallets, the front of this computer, our hardcover print of Outliers by Malcolm Gladwell, the corner of Stacy's monitor, and every single one of John's family photos that were placed on his desk.
McGuire, again? What the
Fundamentally, this site is built around that user story. All those content notes from our content strategy work are right here. And because we started with the content, we knew exactly what to ask for when following up with Rebecca. She sent us project photos, details, team member information, everything we'll need. And with client projects like this, a lot of the build process involves reaching out to the client for more content. Now, we've broken down this site build into distinct parts, and we've done that so we can cover every detail with extreme focus. It might seem a little bit tedious, but that's the point. We're doing this, we're going in this much detail so we don't skip over any of the steps involved. And as we make mistakes or change our mind, we'll adapt and correct as we go. Five things to cover briefly in this introduction. We'll talk about building this site from scratch. We'll cover fluid and responsive layouts. We'll add our image assets. We'll add the fonts we'll use. And finally, that was five. Those are the five things we'll cover in this video. By the end of this video, we'll be ready to dig into layout. And we'll cover the first part, and that's starting with a blank canvas. We're not using a template for our client. There's nothing wrong with that, but we want complete control over building this site from the ground up. And for this build, we'll be using Webflow here to speed things up and visually manipulate our HTML, our CSS, all the building blocks. But of course, if you'd like, you can follow along if you're hand coding this in a code editor. Most of the underlying principles are the same. And if you're not familiar with web development, or you've never built a site from scratch, or especially if for any reason you think you can't develop a site from scratch, we're going to work to change that mindset. And we'll build this whole website for Hayes Valley Interior Design. We're taking our content strategy notes, and we're using that information architecture we developed to build the site. Now, how are we going to do that? Well, we're going to cover each part using modern web technologies like Flexbox and CSS grid and breakpoints to ensure the site is fluid and responsive. And we'll use both those terms a lot, fluid and responsive. Fluid, as in there are things that scale or reflow in a fluidic way. That is, parts of the design we'll make take up the space of their container. This is not the design we'll make. It's not even real words. It's lorem ipsum. But it's fluid. Notice how the content, just like water in a malleable container, responds and reflows as that container, the thing holding it, changes size. It's not magic, but it's a huge thing. And as we refine that skill of building fluid layouts, our designs can live and breathe instead of being entirely fixed like a PowerPoint that simply gets tinier on a smaller device. We want elements of our layout to be fluid, to respond based on the container they're in. But we can go further. Responsive layouts. The thing about responsive layouts is we can reconfigure them. When we hit a certain spot, maybe we're considering people visiting the site from tablets or mobile devices, we can alter the layout. We can change the styling to fit the space provided. Okay, image assets. We'll just reach outside of the screen recording here, grab a bunch of images that Rebecca sent us, and drag them right inside. So, let's move into fonts. We can swap these out later, but for now, from our blank canvas, before we begin layout, we're going to add two fonts. We'll add these from Google Fonts. The first one we want to add is Playfair Display, just typing the letter P here to skip to the fonts that start with that letter. We can scroll down and pick the font from the dropdown. Once we do that, we can choose whatever weights we want. Any variations we can choose here. Once we add the font, we can use it. But before we go back to the designer, let's add one more. We'll go in and add Source Sans Pro, which is another font we'll want to add here from the list. Let's choose the right font weights, and then once we're done doing that, and we're done making sure everything is saved, we're good to go back to the designer. And that's it. We went from a design that looks like this to a design that looks like this, which, as it's being shown, is probably not that impressive. That means it's time to move into layout, and this is where we'll build out the entire hero section using grid.